Hi, Mr. and Mrs. Kleba and Genevieve over at Bergstrom Lexus and Appleton, sitting inside your brand new car. I just thought that I would take a few minutes to make a quick video for you to show you some of the different features from your 13 to the 14, because this car does have the navigation system in it, so there's a few other little things that you're going to get along with that. So here we go. The first thing I want to show you is in the side view mirror here. If you watch on the left side of the side view mirror, there's a feature called blind spot monitor, and that orange light that you see right now will light up when anybody is in the blind spot of the car, and it does it on either on the left side or the right side, just obviously depending on what side of the car the car is in the blind spot. You also, moving down here, still have your memory seating. Window controls are the same. Unlocking and locking is the same. That blind spot monitor button is actually right down here, right next to it, and you can tell that it's on because this little green light is on. Right next to it is the parking sensor button. You have these on your current car. That is going to light up this green P in the instrument panel to let you know that it's on. And those are sensors in the front and rear bumper of the car that beep at you when you get too close to things. The car does still have auto mode for the headlights. They'll just turn off and on automatically. This car does have rain sensing wipers. So let me get it where it's a little in focus a little bit better. So if I push all the way up and let go, it just wipes the windshield one time. And then it goes back to off. So that's where we're at right now, is off. So if I pull it down one time from off, the next thing that's on there is auto. So in the current car you have, there's an intermittent mode that's right here that you can speed up and slow down with this little toggle right here. But in auto mode, they're rain sensing wipers. So anytime any moisture hits the windshield, the wipers will just come on all by themselves, and then you can speed them up and slow them down with this little button right here. Then if you can see, right under auto is low, and then all the way down is high. So I can still manually put the windshield wipers on. So to get it back in auto mode, it's all the way up and let go to be at off, and then one down, and now you're in auto mode. Your cruise control right down here is the same that it is in the 13. On the left side of the steering wheel are your audio controls. That is the same. On the right side are controls for the Bluetooth audio and voice commands for the car as well. You still have your analog clock. The radio controls are the same as they are as well, where it's broken up into radio and media, and they all function the same, but you have a different mouse here now to control everything that's up on the screen, so I'll go over that with you in just a second here. Your climate controls are still the same as well. We have dual climate control on either side of the car. You also have the auto mode that you can push and just set the car to whatever temperature you want, and it'll kick in, increase and decrease the fans on its own. Heated seats and air-conditioned seats. I can't remember if you have the air-conditioned seats or not in your car, but if you're on the red side, it's heating the seat. If it goes on the blue side, it's actually blowing air-conditioned air through these perforated holes in the leather. And it's got that for both the driver's side and the passenger side, of course. The button that is right next to the heated seat is your heated steering wheel, and that is going to heat up the parts here of the leather on the steering wheel. Actually, it's not the bottom part. It's only just the two sides. And then the button that's right here brings up and down your power sunshade just with a push of a button right there. And then you still have the adjustable transmission, where you can turn it to the left to make the car in an eco mode, where it drives in a way that's going to give you the best fuel efficiency. And then you see that it says eco right there on your instrument panel. Then you can also turn it to the right and put it in the sport mode. And it actually makes everything red about here. And that just shifts the car at a higher RPM to give you a little snappier response and quicker pickup and acceleration. And if I push that in the middle, it puts it back into the normal mode, where the car just drives like normal. Cup holders are still in the same spots right here. They split them up, one right there and one right here. And then in your center console, you still have storage. And then up against this little wall right here, I'm sure it's probably impossible to see, but there are two openings for a USB plug and an auxiliary plug. And then right next to it, a round opening that looks like a cigarette lighter, but it's a opening for your cell phone charger. So then you still have, moving up here, your moonroof controls and interior lights. You still have the safety connect button right here. You still have your home link systems. We can program up to three different garage door openers right here. And you still, of course, have your moonroof. We're just inside right now. And then, of course, your moonroof controls. Open and close, tilting the car up and down. So that is actually all of the basic features in the car that I wanted to show you. I'm going to actually make a separate video for you and go over a little bit more with the navigation system. That way, if you ever need to watch any of these separately, you don't have to watch through the whole part of the car to get to the nav part. So I'll do that right here. Here we go.